What up, bitches? It's the Boulder Ghost 5000 back with more Ocarina of Time. In the last episode, we did the latter half of the Fire Temple. In this episode, we're going to go through that boss door. Whoa. Oh, you know what? I have to go around, don't I? Because I can't make this jump. How annoying. How very annoying. How very truly, saddeningly annoying. Here we go. Thankfully, we already have the boss key, so we don't have to do any other crap here. Let's go. What the hell? Some kind of tic-tac-toe board? Look at that boss arena. It's like a tic-tac-toe board. A tic-tac-toe board. All right, let's see. Kind of see how Volvagia likes ice arrows. If they even bother her at all. I don't know why. I'm pretty sure Volvagia isn't canonically any gender or sex, but I always thought of her as I always thought of it as female, mostly just because the name and also its design looks kind of feminine. Wow! Subterranean Lumbering Volvagia! Although, man, it sure doesn't look that impressive now. This is a boss fight that if they ever made like a remake of this game, like in the same vein as the remake of Final Fantasy VII, I would be really excited to see what they did to this boss. Like, how they would change this boss. Watch out! Volvagia, it's the boss of the Fire Temple, revived by the Evil King. I don't know its weak point, ooh-woo! Well, that doesn't do anything. Holy shit! Oh my god, yeah, and Volvagia does a lot of damage, so you gotta be careful. Like that just right there, that did like a bunch of damage. Ooh, that actually worked. Okay, so basically what you want to do, what you have to do here is you have to hit her in the head first. That's the only way you can get her to. That's the only way you can make it weak, make render Volvagia vulnerable. And which when Volvagia does this. I find the best thing to do is to just stand here with your shield out, because it'll make you crouch. I think what you need to worry about there is getting hit by its hands that are like dangling down. It's like weird dangly hands. This boss fight is pretty easy though. I mean, I think the hair there can hurt you. I wonder how much damage those ice arrows do, because I've never even tried using anything other than the sword against this boss, so. Oh, you're going up into the sky. Wait, can I, are you like up there? Yeah, you are. You're actually like knocking boulders down. Wild, and you can actually, where the boulders fall down actually does follow where Volvagia is. So if you could somehow like look up there. All right, jeez. Oh my God, stop it. Like, good Lord. If you could somehow, like, get the camera pointed up, that would, like, help a lot. I'm just gonna, just... Oh, yeah, if you actually have the hammer out... Ooh. Ooh, this is tight. Okay, no, the hands do not hurt you. All right. Then I officially have no idea what the point of this attack is. I don't think I've ever in my life gotten hit by Volvagia when they were doing that. Just seems like totally pointless. Yeah, I guess the idea is that Volvagia is supposed to have like an armored head, but it sure doesn't look like it. It just looks like, you know, I mean, because like nothing goes away after you hit it with the Megaton Hammer. Man, four hits. I wonder how much damage that was doing. I don't remember how many hits that would take if I was like using the Master Sword, but that with four hits with ice arrows is pretty good, you know. Oh no, it's gyrating and pulsating and squelchating. That's scary, man. Thunk! Scary. You can keep locking onto it until after it disappears because its head is still on the ground. And there's the heart container. Oh my god! Yeah, there's the heart container. Yeah, some commentary. Alright, let's get out of here. Say goodbye to that cool boss room, because you'll never see it again. Until you replay the game, that is, obviously. Oh, by the way, I fixed the texture on the on the shield. I fixed up the outline of the frame of it. Whoa! My God, look at that guy's pants. I never realized how ridiculous that guy's pants were. It's erupting into the sky and... Okay, that's weird. Well, there you go. Oh, man, after this weird... Oh, God, these bloops and gurgles in this area are so uncomfortable. Like, the sound... It's like the sound of water, but it sounds like an upset stomach, man.
Thank you, brother. I really appreciate what you did. I thank you on behalf of the entire Goron race. You turned out to be a real man, just as I thought you would. And I'm dead. By the way, I, the Wild Darunia, turned out to be the Great Sage of Fire. Isn't that funny, brother? Well, this must be what they call destiny. Nothing has made me happier than helping you seal the evil here. My brother is in trouble there. Hey, brother, take this. This is a medallion that contains the power of the fire spirits and my friendship.
Man! And my friendship. Good Lord. He had another pinkish red thing. Like, you'd think it would be like... You'd think it would be more orangey red considering it's fire. You know, nothing in nature is like pinkish red other than like flowers, I guess. Actually, I guess pinkish red is arguably more natural than orangish red because... You know, fire, I think in a perfect world, you know, fire wouldn't be like, well, no, fire is natural. So, like, nature deals with overgrowth, I guess. It's kind of like the natural balance. Man, I got one arrow left. Anyway, okay, so now we're out of the place. Yeah, we're out of the place. Uh-huh. Hi! And with the Megaton Hammer, now we can break these big rocks. Like this. It takes two hits, though. Oh, man, there's a grotto here? I didn't know that. Ah. Oh, and with the Megaton Hammer, we can also get these guys up. And they say, I surrender! Oh, gimme! Oh, God! Knock it off! Oh, yeah, I'll buy 30 arrows for 70 rupees. Fuck yeah. Oh, stop it. Jeez. Bombs? I can't have this now. Okay. Ow. But what we can do... Oh, man, that heart piece is taunting me. I really would love to get that heart piece. Dude, go. Don't! Okay. Man, how satisfying would it be if you could, like, break all the pots in your immediate vicinity by hitting the ground with the Megaton Hammer and, like, the quake would cause them to shatter. That'd be so badass. That would make the Megaton Hammer, like, more useful if it had more of that area of effect thing to it. Here we go! Great Fairy's Fountain. Play the Zelda's Lullaby and we can get, I believe, an increased magic meter. And I would have loved to get this before going into the fire temple, but it ended up not really mattering, so that's fine. Nice shot of the shield there. Ah, ha, 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 ha. Oh, man. Welcome, people of Thousand. I'm the Great Fairy of Wisdom. I'm going to enhance your magic power. Yay. Receive it now. Hoo-ah. And I'm going to take a drink out of the smoothie that I made, which is apple cucumber with flax seeds. Mmm. what kind of a camera shot is that? Geez, it isn't enough that these exhibitionist great fairies are on full display. You gotta get a shot up my skirt too. Good Lord. Jeez! What's with these, like, you know, bottom-up crotch shots in this? Let's get out of here, man. And now that we've destroyed that rock, we can thankfully finally cross this. My gut is telling me that that might stay that way, even if you go back to being a kid, which would be hilarious, but I wouldn't be surprised if I was wrong. Anyway. Man, that shield looks good. Fuck yeah. Yeah. It's not as jarring as I expected it to be to have, like, a whole new shield design there. I think largely because, you know, when you play, like, Majora's Mask, you get used to seeing, like, weird, out-of-the-ordinary shields, because first of all, like, the hero's shield in that game is totally random. Like, it doesn't look like anything. It doesn't look like anything consistent with the rest of the series. But then also, is that all the gold Skull was on Death Mountain? No? It ain't. That's strange. Where the hell could the last one be? Or the remaining ones be, I suppose. I got no idea. Curious. Very curious. You know what? Oh, hey, cool, rupees. I'm actually going to play Epona's song for this cow. I am calling my horse, cause I want her to come. That's what makes me feel so good, I can produce a lot of milk. Sorry, that reminded me of Neanders. I wonder if she was quoting this game when she said that. Okay, my rumble is working. It was weird. When I killed Volvagia, there wasn't any rumble at all, and it was really disconcerting. Because if any point in the game would have had a lot of rumble, I would have expected Volvagia's death animation to be it. Ah, here we go. Violent picture. Okay, is that everything on Death Mountain now? No? What do you mean no? How could that not be everything on Death Mountain? How dare you, first of all, how dare you? Second of all. I need to keep it nighttime if I want to keep hunting these things down. I wonder if doing a jump attack would destroy these things in one go. Nah. That's disappointing. I'd be able to hear it if there was one underneath any of these rocks. I don't know where the rest of the gold skulls are in this area. I felt sure that was it when we got the last one under the rock. I don't know. How strange. If only there was like a stone of agony for skulls, you know? That'd be nice. Alright. Now what do we do? I can't really think of much else to do besides just move on to our next quest. You know, which would probably be to go to the water... to the water temple, which we've been able to do for, like, a few episodes. What?
Those iron boots look like they weigh a ton. If you wear those boots, you may be able to walk at the bottom of a lake.
A lake? You know, it doesn't matter which lake, just any old lake. Only take off the Goron tunic, I don't need this thing on anymore. Look at my shield, good lord, man. Crazy. Maybe I should try swapping that out for a higher res texture, because I'm pretty sure I could. I'm pretty sure I could use a higher res texture, because I actually drew the texture for the shield at 10 times the native texture, the native resolution of the shield texture, but I scaled it all the way down before I imported it. But I probably could, you know, not do that, because I am using, like, you know, I'm not using an HD texture pack, but I am using, like, a 1080p resolution hack in the emulator. So, like, most everything looks smoother, and maybe it would look nice if I did that for the shield, too. I'm just looking for Skulltulas, man. But I'm not gonna find any if I just wander around like an idiot. Oh, by the way, that unlock we got lets us do this. It gives us a second level to our sword beam that makes it go even further. Or our sword, our spin attack, you know? Ah, hello, my horsey. You've been waiting there for me all this time? What do we do? I already checked this, right? This was where I was so surprised to be able to find that I could actually do this without the Song of Storms. Yeah, this was where I found out that you actually open this with bombs, not the Song of Storms, which I found very strange. Yeah, sure enough. But I've already been down here. I know, because I was down here already. Yes. I already got the Skulltula that was in here. Alright, never mind. Oh, you know what we can do now is we could go do that. There's a heart piece out here that we can get with the iron boots. Although I would like to get it using a different item that'll be much, much, much harder to get. I don't know if that's really worth it. Basically, there's a little side quest over at Lake Hylia that, if you do it right now, you can actually do it as both as an adult and as a kid. And if you do it as an adult, you get an upgrade to your scale. The one that lets you dive deeper that we got in Zora's Domain as a child, you get an upgrade to it. So I don't know why I haven't already done that. Bum, bum, ba-da-da-da. Well, you know what? Actually, there is another thing that you can get with the, that you're, well, you can jury-rig both of those, though. There are two heart pieces in this game that you're supposed to get with that upgraded scale, which I guess I'll just come out and say it's the gold scale. But you can trick the game into giving you both. You can get one. You can get this one with the iron boots, and you can get the other one with a trick using the iron boots, which is really cheap, but it's funny, so I might even, like, show it. Right. It's over here. Oh, man, nice hit there. Yeah, this heart piece down here. You're supposed to get this with the gold scale, but you can get it with the iron boots. I think you're supposed to get it with the gold scale. I mean, honestly, it doesn't really matter. But the other thing you can get, you're definitely supposed to get with the gold scale. There's also a pretty big side quest that I'm pretty sure we could do right now that would allow us to replace our broken giant's knife with something a little bit better. Yeah, subtle. You know, nobody can guess what you're talking about there. But the thing is, I don't really want to do it yet, because I'd like to do, you know, I'd like to wait a little while longer before I get that, because once I do, I'm never going to stop using it, you know? Bum, 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 boom, ba-da-loo-loo. Ba-da-loo-loo. Ba. Yeah, so we're going to go over to, like, Hylia. We're already up to 19 minutes here, so, like, I don't know if I should really be doing anything else in this episode, but, well, who cares? We can do a little bit of side questing over, like, we can do a little bit of side questing here at Lake Hylia before we take on the Water Temple. There's actually something that I'm really kicking myself for not having done before. As a kid, there's actually a magic bean spot here that I neglected to plant anything at, but actually, wait a second. You can call Pierre here? If we can call Pierre here, then that would solve the problem. Yeah, sure enough. Can I reach him with the basic hookshot? I don't think I can. Looks like I might be a little bit too far. Oh, maybe. Hey, I can! What do you know? Okay, now before we go up this ladder, you want to take out these Gways because they'll knock you down otherwise. They absolutely will fuck you up. Or any more? I can literally hear one. Like, I can hear one. Yeah, I knew you were there. Nice. At the top of this ladder is, I believe, another heart piece. Oh, and you know what? There's a Skulltula here, too, that we can get. I think we can get this as an adult. There you go! There's 15 heart containers! Oot! Shoot! No, I think I'd be able to hear it if the Skulltula was there. Yeah, it's not there as an adult. We have to come back as a kid. But we're gonna have to come back here as a kid later, anyway. Because there'll be another Skulltula underneath the magic bean spot. Which, apparently, those things don't even appear when you're an adult. Which I didn't realize. I thought they would appear there and just be empty, but apparently they don't appear at all, unless you've already planted something there. In which case, the bean sprout will be there. Now I don't think we can actually do this. We can't actually reach the fishing hole as an adult, which is over there. The fishing hole is over there. We can't actually reach that as an adult. Unless we have the, until we either complete the dungeon or, you know, unless we either complete the dungeon or have the magic bean planted. So what I might actually do is, oh man, you know what I just realized? I never actually went back to the Temple of Time. I have yet to go back to the Temple of Time, and Sheik has been waiting there since I finished the Forest Temple to give me something, and I just totally forgot to go back and get it. That would have been so awesome if I'd landed that shot. So that's what we're going to do. Okay, next time on Ocarina of Time, we will head back to the Temple of Time, and we're actually going to do some fishing before we head on to the Water Temple, because I want to get some heart pieces. Yeah. So, bye!